Staticus are in Belfast and we're delighted to be talking to the team at Tughans. Tughans is one of the largest leading commercial law firms in Northern Ireland and they've been operating here in the city for 121 years. Through a series of Staticus chats, we'll be talking about many of the legal fundamentals a startup will need to know as they grow and scale their business. So we are joined by Patricia Rooney, who works for the employment team at Tughans Solicitors in Belfast. Patricia, thank you so much for joining us. So Patricia, I just want to ask, this is around employee relationships or when that breaks down, that relationship. So what do you do as a business if an employer comes to you and they want to raise a complaint or an issue directly with you as a business?
Well, the first thing not to do is to dismiss it out of hand. You should ask the employee to put their complaint in writing. It doesn't have to be very lengthy. And then when you've done that, you should then start investigating what concerns the employee has raised. If possible, and I know it doesn't always apply, if possible, someone should investigate it, speak with the employee, and then give a written outcome and allow the employee the right of appeal against that. The employee also can be accompanied at the meeting, so that is a companion for the employee. But as I've said, the important thing is to treat it seriously.
Okay, perfect. So one would assume a lot of business owners maybe take some things as quite trivial, which maybe aren't, and flip the vice versa of that.
And what's important is to remember it's what the employee thinks the issue is, not what his colleague or what management think. And also, because as lawyers do, remember to keep good notes and good records, because what starts off as something very trivial could escalate and could end up in tribunal.
So in a basic sense, it's due diligence, making sure that you've ticked the boxes. You know, obviously follow the process, would
yes.
that be fair?
And I think one of the important things is that one of the requirements is that you must have a grievance policy. So your process and procedure should be set out there. So if you can follow that, you'll be doing well.
Perfect. And following on from that, in your experience, is that a typical issue that you face within the employment team at Tughans? Is experiencing that where
yes.
that process hasn't been followed?
Yes, because one of the things also to remember is that if the grievance ends up escalating and there's a breakdown in the relationship and you end up dismissing that person, the reason for dismissal obviously has to be fair, but the process is just as important. Mm-hmm. So not following a process can lead to a finding against the employer simply by, you know, slipping down or not mm-hmm. keeping notes or not having proper procedure in place.
So simply by default you're putting yourself in a situation of danger?
Yes, which you can avoid mm-hmm. just by taking a few simple steps.
Perfect. So Patricia, the flip of that would be that an employer has an issue with an employee's conduct or their performance. So talk us through the process. What should an employer do to make sure that they're looking after themselves there as well?
Again, it is process driven. And put your complaint in writing to the employee. It is not enough simply to come to a knee-jerk reaction that the particular employee is supposed to have done A, B and C and you haven't investigated. So again, process is to put in writing the complaint, allow the employee an opportunity to answer what you're alleging against him, and again, a companion at that meeting. If possible, you have different people dealing with different stages of that. It's not always possible in startup companies, mm-hmm. so you do what you can in the circumstances. But again, do not come to a knee-jerk reaction. If you investigate and you uphold the complaint against that employee, you give a written outcome and the right of appeal. Mm-hmm. And those are legal processes which you must follow. So particularly if you're looking at a disciplinary, which might end in dismissal, it's extremely important that you follow those. Mm-hmm.
So we often get told that startups should act like established businesses. And this seems to me, in terms of HR, this seems like a core area where you must have the right processes in place.
Absolutely. Now, if you unfortunately ever end up in a tribunal will not expect a startup to have the resources mm-hmm. that the likes of huge multinational would have, but they would expect the organisation to act reasonably. Mm-hmm. And if you start with that premise, that I must act reasonably and fairly, that's a good place to start.
Okay, perfect. So a lead on from that would be, how do you set up the process in terms of how you manage people to ensure that you have that process in place from the outset when you're employing people?
You will have a disciplinary policy, which hopefully will set out the policy, the procedure, what you think is a ground for starting the disciplinary process. For example, you know, what misconduct you think would be inappropriate or what performance levels you would expect. And then within that, you will have various steps set out. But the very first one is putting the complaint in writing and allowing the employee an opportunity to be heard.
Okay, perfect. In terms of employer performance, would that go back to someone's initial contract that they've been given, which outlines the job role, or is it something that you can work on as you go?
It's always helpful if you have a job description with your contract, because then everyone understands what that employee is supposed to be doing. Mm-hmm. So if there is a complaint about poor performance, you have the basic understanding of what the job should be. So you can go back to the job description. But it doesn't mean you wait until it is so bad that it can't be addressed. You know, if you have conversations along the way, hopefully that will, you know, avoid the necessity of disciplinary action.
Yeah, and that's obviously the what you want to do is get to the point where you don't have to discipline because it's been managed accordingly.
Exactly.
Perfect.
If it's to be, you might put targets in place and have regular meetings with the employee because you are managing that performance. And then both have a working relationship.
Okay, so Patricia, we've got to the point where you want to dismiss an employee and you've gone through that process and you've followed due diligence, but you're concerned that maybe that employee has information or they've got access to data. What should you do to make sure that obviously you're protecting your business?
Well, hopefully your contract has put in the contract itself from the very outset of the relationship what obligations you expect that employee to follow when they leave, and there will be something in there that deals with your confidential information and your IP. So if you dismiss an employee, or even at the end of a relationship where the employee is just going somewhere else, you will write and remind that individual of his or her obligations, including the return of confidential information, whatever social media accounts, LinkedIn addresses, etc. There is, if that doesn't work, there is always the possibility then of taking legal action. And that is a formal letter requiring undertakings that the individual will comply with the obligations regarding confidential information and IP. And the worst case scenario is that you can take legal proceedings against that individual to have him return your confidential information, client list data, etc., and undertakings regarding the IP that he or she might have.
Perfect. It sounds quite a serious process, but one assumes it's best to follow that process.
It is quite serious. It is also very expensive because it has to be done immediately. If you think that your employee has taken your information, clearly you want to protect your business as quickly as you can.
Yeah.
So it has to be done extremely quickly. Mm-hmm. And it is a very serious complaint to raise against an individual employee that he has effectively stolen what belongs to you.
And obviously one thing that you flagged up that I and perhaps many other people wouldn't have thought about as well is that most people leave on good terms.
Yes.
But you still have to have that process in place to make sure they're reminded of their obligations.
Yes. As employment lawyers, we draft employment contracts and policies, both in relation to the relationship might end in a very good place and you might have a continuing working relationship, or if it goes wrong. So you have to have your...
So,
provisions there if it goes
wrong. That's what I was saying. So to end it on, make sure you manage all your employees with the same process, irrespective.
Exactly. Equality.
Equality for
fair
all.
Fair treatment.
Yeah. Perfect. Great stuff, Patricia. It's been great chatting.
Thank you.
And thank you for much for all your advice as well.
Thanks very much.
Great.
Thank you.
Thank you.